An echo of an echo is the semblance of a sound. And I press and I've waited with my ear upon the ground.
Oh, lover, I'll see you there, waiting in the willows with your autumn hair. Oh, lover, I'll see you there, after many miles.
Oh, the drop shot. I didn't even teach you that.
Oh.
How'd it do?
Not bad.
Sit. Don't. I love the ocean.
She hit it too good. Nice job.
It's the moment where everyone in Portland, the makers, the doers, the business owners, the entrepreneurs, the influencers, come together and hang out and reconnect. And also, maybe find a little love.
Hi, I'm John Rennie from Rennie's, and hope you're all having a great time. It's winter now in Maine, and Maine's a beautiful state in all seasons. And I've been here for 71 years, and our company's been here for 73 years, and we know what you need because we live here. Thanks for watching, everybody. Maine life is the best life. Thanks for coming to Rennie's, and we'll see you soon. Rennie's,
a Maine adventure.
Hey folks, welcome to this special edition episode of Maine Life Offseason, the arts and entertainment version. Chris Davis co-hosting today with Aaron O'Valley. Now there are so many great things to do this time of year outside, but there's also a lot to celebrate and support inside. So we're gonna be squashing, golfing, and checking out the Arts District of Portland. And right now, I'm gonna learn how to play squash.
I'm Barrett Takesian. I'm the executive director of Portland Community Squash. We are standing at 66 Noyes Street in Portland. This is the first community squash center of its kind in the United States. We started with really strong youth programs. We start in third grade, two and through college. We've worked with hundreds, maybe a thousand or so youth at this point in time. We've been operating here at Noyes Street since 2017. But our organization goes all the way back to the YMCA. We started in 2013 as an effort to create opportunities for kids, athletic, academic support, wellness programs, travel, mentorship. But through that, we got to know all the amazing families around Portland as well. And we've grown into a multi-generational community center serving about 500 families, representing 26 countries of origin, 17 languages. We've got all the amenities of a great gym, but we've got all the fun as well. The great thing about our center is it's all about three things. It's about pathways to opportunity. It's also about relationships. Your social capital is worth more than your math scores. That's not my opinion, that's just fact. And then lastly, you're nothing without your health. So we focus on well-being, mental and physical health.
The only difference between tennis and squash, you've played some tennis, I can tell. You got a nice closed face. You're used to working the ball over the net.
Yeah.
But in squash, we got a 17-foot wall that you can hit the ball as hard as you want against.
I love that part
of this
sport.
It's like playing tennis.
Yeah.
But I tell you, you get to hit a home run every time.
Okay.
You just blast the ball out of the court. Okay? So on the forehand, it's a nice open face. And then on the backhand, we just turn our wrist down.
Yeah.
Like that. And that's it. When you serve, you have to have 1 foot in the little box. You have to hit the ball above the service line. And it has to land on the opposite side of the court, in the back.
Got it, okay.
So if we were gonna play a point, you'd probably stand somewhere in this box right here. Nice. Give it space.
It hurts a little inside when I don't hit it.
Oh, that's nice. Oh, the drop shot. I didn't even teach you that.
Keep in mind, folks, he's still wearing his pants. Wow! All right, he turned it up a notch.
I don't think it's the pants. 10-9.
Yep.
That was good, though, baby.
That is awesome.
That's your first game.
In our first 6 years of operations, we were really focused on guided programs, so staff delivering, teaching the game, teaching academic sessions, teaching wellness, teaching youth how to form relationships. But the really powerful work happens in our self-guided programs. And that's where we're investing our resources now. We're expanding the facility. At a certain point, students and their families need to come in on their own time for events, to play squash, to give back and volunteer, to hopefully eat in our cafe. So we're really investing in these self-guided programs, and those self-guided programs are where all that community cohesion happens. So rather than the value coming from staff to participant, the power that we're all working towards is when that help is coming community member to community member. It's a lot more financially sustainable, it's more powerful, and it has this exponential factor that you don't get when you're just staff to participant, because that's, you know, we only have so much energy to give as staff members, right?
Thank you so much. You bet, bud. I really want to play more. Yeah. Thank you for the lessons, and thanks for tuning in. And hey, Aaron, how'd I do?
Thank you, Chris. I know you had a blast, and I hope you brought back some really good moves. I have been to Portland Community Squash, and I'm so impressed by all that Barrett and his crew are doing, not only for the Portland and surrounding community, but also our youth. As is my friend here, Brian Bickford, owner of Sim City in Westbrook. We're gonna check in to see all that he is doing for junior golf, and also check in on my rusty golf swing, but we're gonna have fun. Let's go. Hey, friend.
Hey, Aaron, how you doing?
Good.
Welcome to Sim City. Hope you enjoy your round today.
Thank you. I'll try my best.
All right.
It's busy today.
It is busy, but it's a snowy day in Maine. Sim City is in its fifth year in business. We had started originally at Valhalla as the tee box for about 4 years, and then we've moved over to Westbrook. It's a bigger market, for sure, than the town of Cumberland. But also the growth of Westbrook and Rock Row, and just the area in general is very easy to get to, just off the interstate, and that makes it convenient for a whole host of people. We have 8 indoor simulators, and that generally is, you know, 32 people, but it can accommodate a few more per sim. We also have capacity here at both the bar and a little bit around the bar and restaurants.
With golf becoming more and more year-round with a place like Sim City, you know, we've had the idea of being able to offer junior programming all year round, and with as busy golf as has become during the season, we can utilize this in the summer for junior programming as well. We offer youth on course, which is something we brought about 3 years ago back into Maine. It's a great program where kids can sign up for $5 through youthoncourse.org. We're up to 24 courses that are on board in the state, and they get to play golf for as little as $5. We were actually just awarded a silver medal from Youth on Course, a national Youth on Course, for our efforts in the last couple years. We're just over 1,200 kids in the state that have signed up for the program, which is, it's huge. It's something I wish I had growing up as a kid. I was hanging out at golf courses all day and paying for it, and, you know, to be able to go play this great game for $5 or less is something that's pretty unique and special, and nationwide it's taken off. It's in all 50 states.
All right, we are now here with the director of golf, Clint. Clint, tell us what's behind us.
This is our AG simulator about golf, it's just a multiple of things. You can play holes on it. You can hit the driving range. There's multiple of games that you can play, mini golf, darts. Cornhole.
I might be better at cornhole than I am at golf, my friend, but we're gonna try today. So how many courses can you play?
We have up to 80 golf courses.
Wow.
Yeah. There you go.
Nice, that was better, right? Even though
way
it
better.
Didn't go high.
I mean, making progress, right?
Felt better.
Honestly, swinging the club is the most important part of the game.
Yep.
Just to get beginners
and
swinging.
Fun.
Exactly. Don't worry about the rules. Too many beginners worry about the rules when they first start.
Yeah.
Don't worry about the rules. Just play to have fun. That's the main goal.
Well, I'm having fun.
There you go.
That was only because you were there. That is pretty.
Oh.
How'd it do?
Not bad.
Really?
Sit.
Oh, drop, don't. I love the ocean. I love the ocean.
She hit it too good. Nice job.
The environment is 70 degrees and it's always sunny in here. And so they like that. You don't have to fight the elements, if you will. Sims in Maine do about 60,000 rounds of winter golf, which 10 years ago was zero. and now it's 60,000. And so that's a big number and a big economic impact for a lot of golf courses, whether they're freestanding or have a standalone site like this. There's definitely an economic impact by offering indoor golf in Maine.
Cheers to that. Well, we've got a lot of fun outdoor golf stuff happening. We've got Golf right. Across Maine starting up again. And
right.
Some Drive for Kids celebrity golf tournament. That's going to be fun.
Drive chip and putt, spring golf, some of the best golf. So
yeah, cheers to that.
All right.
Good to see you.
Good to see you. Thank
fun.
You for coming in.
A hard day at work.
Cheers. Yeah.
Cheers.
When was the last time you had this much fun driving? Follow your adventures in an exciting new Honda. Buy online, reserve from select dealers, or visit your local Honda dealer today.
Winter in Maine. We never know what we're going to get, but we are always ready. This winter, the MaineLife crew couldn't wait for Mother Nature to bring us snow. As soon as there was a dusting, we were off. In our new 2023 Honda CR-V, we explored Western Maine. Cross-country skiing, bat biking, and of course, warming up with some delicious food and fresh coffee. From there, we traveled to Rumford for a fun and fast ride down Black Mountain. Wherever our snowy travels take us, our CR-V can safely get us there. The Maine Honda dealers are saying that the 2023 CR-V is bold, sophisticated, and capable, and we agree. This all-new 6th generation CR-V has improved handling and a more comfortable ride, while also having the largest storage capacity in its class with room for a lot of gear. So drive and discover a new destination this winter and know that all 2023 CR-Vs have peace of mind with the new Honda Service Pass. Get your 2023 Honda CR-V at any of your Maine Honda dealer locations. Happy adventuring!
We always have great prices at Rennie's. And my dad, when he started the business 73 years ago, said, you know, even though you get a really good deal, pass it on, you know, because your customer will remember that they got a great deal, even though you probably could have got a little bit more money for it, they'll know. We have about 10 buyers that travel the country and on the phone, on Zoom, all the time trying to find deals. And as I said, we have great vendors who call us first.
Welcome back. Aaron, Pebble Beach looked beautiful. Now we are in the heart of the Arts District right here in Portland on Congress Street. We are going to check out Mechanics Hall, one of the original art institutions right here in Portland, Maine. They have a member-supported library. I don't even know what that means, but it sounds amazing. So let's go learn from the executive director.
I'm Annie Leahy, and I am the executive director here at Mechanics Hall in Portland, Maine. You are sitting in the 8th oldest member-supported library in the United States, which is pretty incredible. It's pretty incredible that this library is still here. It's pretty incredible that this building is still here. In the 1800s, there were no public libraries. For you to have access to literature, you were most certainly of a certain class. And so there was this movement that was born originally in the United Kingdom, but then eventually came to the United States, of building these mechanics institutes. And they were designed for people who worked in creative environments. They were designed for, in those days, you know, folks who were like cabinet makers and saddle makers and ship builders. And, you know, that was sort of the mechanics of the day. The bookshelves behind me are the original bookshelves that were on the first floor. It's pretty remarkable that we get to sit in this library. Our collection is really driven by our membership, and that's one of the really unique things about member-supported libraries, is that you have a say in what's on our shelves. And so, you know, we're often asking our members, what is it that you want to read? What is it that you're interested in? This library's undergone some significant restoration work, and we were doing a weeding project, and our librarian at the time was going through the books and took off the shelf a first edition copy of Stephen King's Carrie. So we were a little surprised that it was sitting there on the shelf. But the delightful piece of that was that we opened it up, and at some point when the book entered into the collection, someone had clipped out the New York Times review of the book. And I'm not gonna get it exactly right, but the reviewer said something to the effect of, I think that this kid's gonna go someplace. When you enter into the building, you go up one level. This library is on the second floor. And then if you wind your way up to the third floor, you enter one of the most beautiful spaces here in Portland, Maine, the ballroom.
Wow, okay.
I wanna put a little camera up in the corner when we're doing events, because the reaction that people have when they round the staircase and enter this room is often one of awe.
I was gonna say very awe-inspiring.
It's very awe-inspiring, particularly that this ballroom is smack in the middle of Portland's Art District.
Perfectly located.
Perfectly located.
Yeah. And I keep thinking about the members back in the day in their shop grinding away, like they probably had incredible extravagant events here. It must have felt so special.
They had dances and operas and performance and meals and really like tremendous community. Mm-hmm. Tremendous community is really what happened in this space.
I love beams.
Welcome to the Clear Story.
Look at that.
It's beautiful. It is an incredibly, incredibly beautiful space that is currently not open to the public.
Yeah.
But future plans have us adding a second egress so that we can actually utilize this space.
Yeah.
Pretty neat, huh?
Hello, Portland.
Hello, Portland. Hello, Casco Bay.
Nice to be up top.
Hello, Bug Light.
Yes. Oh my goodness.
So can you imagine what it must have been like?
Yeah.
When they finished the building, none of this was here.
Yeah.
So a clear shot.
Anyway, this has been awesome. I just keep thinking we're in the center of Portland, we're in the Arts District.
I know. And I'm
just blown away, one, by this section of the building.
I know.
Thank you for letting us come up
here. Oh my gosh, you're welcome. I really appreciate the enthusiasm, and let's get more people here.
Let's get more people here. Yeah. The library is a great place to come.
Yeah.
You guys have a lot of programming that we talked about.
Lots and lots of programming coming up.
And you have a new national recognition.
We are now on the National Register for National Significance, which is amazing. It really helps protect the future of this building for the next 100 years to come.
Hi, I'm Melissa, and I have been with Rennie's for 15 years as a buyer. I'm from Maine originally, so I really enjoy it here. Great company to work for, really good people. It's fun. I never thought I'd be in the buying world. My background is very different, but I really enjoy it. It's a lot of fun. My favorite part about working at Rennie's, as a buyer anyways, is finding deals for the customers. You never know what you're gonna find when you come to Rennie's, and as a buyer, that's what we're always looking for, that deal, that unique item. It's fun.
We are so honored and proud to help our community this way. We are now over $800,000 in donations throughout New England. I think assisting teachers in their projects and helping kids to achieve their dreams, it's our legacy, and I believe this is a true one cause that every single employee of Berlin City is really proud of. To nominate a teacher, a class, or a school, please look for Keep Driving Foundation on berlincity.com.
Maine is a lifestyle destination. With over 3,500 miles of coastline, lakes, mountains, and four-season recreation, there's a reason Maine is known as vacation land. At Harcourt's Waterfront and Fine Properties, we're the Maine real estate lifestyle experts. If you're thinking about moving to Maine, we can help you not only find a property, but the perfect home to fit your lifestyle. Contact us today to make your dream of living in vacation land come true. Harcourt's, we're with you all the way.
Hi everyone, welcome. I'm happy to host you here at the Portland Museum of Art. It's a wonderful time of year here at the PMA. We have a brand new exhibition open, and of course we have all our wonderful collections installed throughout the galleries. No matter what you really want to see, you can make discoveries here at the PMA that you had no idea about. And so it's just a really wonderful place, a huge collection of more than 18,000 artworks. And you're always going to be surprised with what you see. We're constantly rotating exhibitions and artworks out on the walls. So no experience at the PMA is the same. You're always gonna get something new.
One of the wonderful things about this space is you're not just gonna see art from, you know, local communities, you'll see art from all over Boston area, New York, and international art as well. And as an art lover, that was really the draw for me moving to Maine. It kind of first started with the First Friday Art Walk, and then I thought to myself, like, how can I get more involved and how can I meet more people who share the same love as I?
So you're welcome anytime at the PMA. Our membership starts at just $5 a month, which is really affordable for most folks here in town and throughout Maine. But we also have free opportunities. Every Friday from 4 to 8, we're free and open to everyone. Our store is always open free of charge, and so is our cafe. So we're in probably the most transformative moment in the PMA's 140-year history. We're about to build and embark on a new building and campus unification and expansion project we call the PMA Blueprint. It involves building a new building right next to our main building here on Free Street in Congress Square. And that building is going to add 60,000 feet of free space, gallery space, educational space, and interactive space. Tonight is the party of the year. It's the PMA bash. It's the moment where everyone in Portland, the makers, the doers, the business owners, the entrepreneurs, the influencers, come together and hang out and reconnect. And also maybe find a little love.
I love this event. I really enjoy the Portland community. It's such a vibrant community of people who love art. Being a contemporary is just something that's so much fun. You can network with a lot of different art lovers. This is a great event. It's just so much fun. A lot of young entrepreneurs and people who love the museum, love art.
The contemporaries are a diverse and active group comprised of business owners, community leaders, activists, creatives, and influencers. And everyone just shares the culture of the PMA here, and it's really the heart of the museum, and I'm so happy to be a part of it. A lot of time and energy goes into planning these events. We have a great event planning committee, and it's just a great group of people working together to create this amazing night.
One thing that I love most about this party is I see faces I haven't seen in several years, and it's just a great way to reinvigorate the community and network together with different people who have the shared love of art.
There are a million different ways to engage with the museum, and just give us a call. You can find out more at portlandmuseum.org or visit us right here at 7 Congress Square. Thank you for being here with us at the Portland Museum of Art, and you know, we hope to see you soon.
Spread the love, everyone.
Spread the love.
Welcome to OMaine Studios. Aaron, I think you've been here a few times. Come on in.
At OMaine Studios, we produce some pretty cool TV shows and host all kinds of events in our studio, from weddings, holiday parties, to celebrations of Maine's food and craft-made products. Tonight, we are premiering our ocean episode of our Maker's Way TV series. The dead of winter is a special time when we here at OMaine Studios find it a great time to bring people together to interact directly with Maine artists, makers, and entertainers. From cozy winter clothes, books, pizza kits, to drink mixers, you can find something to help you shake cabin fever.
Wonderful winter creations from Northern Solstice Alpaca. Corey and Robin do an amazing job. And it wouldn't be winter without something warm.
If you love the mountains, we have the handcrafted Amalgam Ski Company from Freeport with their 2023 lineup of custom skis. Makers Nikki and Taylor Stroud from Cape Elizabeth created Rugged Seas. Their custom bags are made from upcycled fishermen bibs with a percentage of sales donated to support Maine commercial fishermen. And you definitely want to check out their sweet hoodies. Of course, you have to try Maine oysters, farmed and shucked by Maine Oyster Company from the cold waters of Harpswell.
Here, let me get a cheers with you. Where's the little minuette? Okay. Cheers.
Aaron, we're so sorry we missed you. I'm sure you had a blast at the Portland Museum of Art. Cheers to Maine in winter. Hope to see you soon.
Thank you for following along on these adventures with Maine Life Offseason, and thank you to our presenting sponsor, Rennie's and News Center Maine. Make sure to like us on Facebook, follow us on Instagram. We'll see you next time.
Went behind the screen. I lost a ball here at SimCity. It's possible. Especially with junior golf, and we'll, what did you say? Checking out, that was a good one too, okay.
Don't play piano, but.
Well, you don't want to play that piano.
I can imagine a world where one who loves piano thinks this might be the most spectacular player.
Maine.